This is the ware room of the shop. This is where we would show you our wares. And these are pieces really all representative of the kind of work you'd find coming out of Tidewater, Virginia. It's a singularly British expression, which actually is very multifaceted at that time. The desk and bookcase is a piece that finished off my apprenticeship. I did that years ago with another cabinet maker, Kelly Blanton. At the time of making, we thought the original was a product of this shop, but it was later determined to have come out of Norfolk, Virginia. Fits in really tightly with a group of cases that are attributed to that region. Just beyond it is a tea table, the original which has a history with the governor's palace, and actually that's where the original table resides today. The foot on this particular table has details that are identical to an artifact that was found on this site. And this is a replica that David Salisbury did in the shop, a good 15 years or so ago. This cabinet on chest, another Tidewater piece, the original, we think, from the peninsula here, is one of few cabinets. A cabinet can be a room, it can be a niche in a room, or it can be a piece of furniture that's used to hold precious items, collections. This, as you can see, is a document cabinet. The dovetail construction here is typical of what you expect in the finer English city pieces with very petite pins. And thin dimension stock. If we take this to the window, this tight-grained and high resin content of longleaf southern yellow pine. So this is a writing cabinet on chest, or document cabinet on chest with writing drawer. So your ledgers, account books will be kept underneath. And we're not sure if it was intended or not. I think it was. On the original, there is a suggestion that this was intended as a concealed compartment, which is not unusual in a day and time when there are yet no banks on this side of the Atlantic Ocean. Beyond it is a spinet that Mr. Wright, our harpsichord maker, and the fellow that mentored him, Marcus Hansen, were responsible for. And as you can see from the name board, more than 20 years ago. Harpsichords are not a product of the cabinet maker shop, but under the mastery of Benjamin Bucktrout, the second man to occupy this site, Mr. Bucktrout also advertised making harpsichords, which we do not understand. He was a cabinet maker, but Mr. Bucktrout did a lot of other things that were outside of his trade. There is so much to share with you. As cabinet makers, it's such a broad repertoire of furniture that you would expect from us, and that we have the privilege and joy of exploring and replicating today. So come into the workroom and see some of the pieces that we currently have under construction.
If you're interested in learning traditional woodworking with hand tools, visit my website at woodandshop.com, where you'll find free video tutorials, buying guides, workshop tours, and reviews. Make sure you subscribe to receive my regular blog posts and YouTube videos, and don't forget to check out my 10 steps for getting started. Enjoy!